Asante. Sisi tunafuraha siku ya leo kumkaribisha Waziri Dr. Fred Matiang'i Trans Nzoia County. Na tunafuraha sana sababu Trans Nzoia ni kama Kenya ndogo. Na yeye akiwa waziri anayesimamia mambo ya National Government Coordination. Na pia anayesimamia mambo ya maendeleo ya serikali kuu. Tunafuraha sana siku ya leo kumkaribisha hapa. Tuangalie miradi ya serikali ambayo inaendeshwa hapa Trans Nzoia, ikiwemo uwanja ndege wetu ambao unaendelea kujengwa ili ndege zianze kuja direct hapa Trans Nzoia, mambo ya maji, mambo ya barabara. Leo tunatembelea miradi hii yote na yeye na timu yetu ya county na vile vile ya region ikiongozwa na bwana Natembea. Mumekaribisha hii timu?
Yes.
So hiyo ndio jambo kubwa limetuleta hapa siku ya leo, na yangu ni kumwambia tu karibu nyumbani, salimia watu wako na twende kazi. Karibu, karibu waziri.
Asante sana. Habari ya wananchi wa Trans Nzoia? Asante sana. Thank you so much my brother and my friend CS Omalwa. And thank you to all my colleagues who are here, starting with our political leaders, Mheshimiwa Kotuni who has accompanied us here. The regional commissioner and the security team in the region, the county commissioner Bwana Ojwang and the county security team, and all of you my colleagues in the public service who are here and who serve our people from this point. First I want to thank you on behalf of my colleagues, your various ministers at the headquarters. I want to say thank you for the service you continue to render to our people from this part of our country. I have been briefed comprehensively about a number of things that are happening here, and I am satisfied that on a broad range of things we are doing well. The areas where we need to work on major improvements, and we will have an opportunity to talk to some of our heads of department and make sure that we deliver services to the level that His Excellency our President wants us to deliver. Trans Nzoia is very important to us, and one indicator is that in our budget, the national government is putting 20 billion shillings in development projects in Trans Nzoia alone. Barabara, maji, the airstrip and so on. We are going to spend a total of about 20 billion shillings between now and the end of the next financial year to complete all these projects. Some of these projects are going well. Some, like the road that we are doing to Swami, is delaying, and we are going to find a solution of dealing with that. I'm going to bring it to the attention of my colleague, the Minister for Transport, who should find a solution to fast track that process. Tuko na shida hapa ya title deeds, and I'm going to address it later on because my colleagues have been working on this. The Minister for Lands and her peers have promised that they will keep the deadline that the President gave. There are some farms here that need to be adjudicated. We sort out some problems like in Nyakinywa, Milimani and the others. I want to assure you that we are determined to ensure that we sort these problems out before the end of this financial year. Some of them are straightforward. We can negotiate some of the challenges we have with the leaders in this place and resolve them. So my first request to you is simply that, as I've told my brother, the regional commissioner and his team, and the county commissioner and his team, we can't all the time use one method of solving our problems, eti tuperekane kotini, tukamate wale, and so on. Wakati mwingine, some of the challenges we have, we can resolve them by sitting down with the leaders here and some of the community leaders and finding solutions. It will be less costly, it will save our time, and we will be able to serve our people better that way. So we are going to negotiate and discuss some of these challenges and resolve them, because there is a way we can deal with them without losing so much time and wasting resources going to court and so on and so forth. I am happy about my colleagues in civil registration. We don't have any backlogs here for birth certificates. I am a little bit unhappy with our National Registration Bureau. We have 6,000 ID cards here that have not been collected, but we are going to work, and the County Commissioner is already putting a structure in place to work with the chiefs and assistant chiefs to ensure that those IDs are all collected as it were. The only saddening thing that I have to say here with a measure of shame and frustration is that this county now is actually leading the country in the number of teenage pregnancies amongst our children. We have 10,000 school-going kids here, you know, who have become pregnant, especially in the last 1 year during the long and unfortunate corona break. Now, the president has directed, and we have kept saying this, I told my colleagues who are here from the Minister of Education, is now government policy, all those children have got to go to school. Whether or not they're expectant, they have to go to school, and teachers are going to work together with the leaders to ensure that we keep those children in school. But I have already asked the county commissioner and the county police commander. Some of these, our girls, were made pregnant by adults. Na wale wengine wako hapa. Yule wa TSC aliniambia they have only disciplined two teachers. Wengine wako pande hii, adults and so on. I have asked the county commissioner and the county police commander, before I leave Trans Nzoia today, they tell me how many people they have arrested. And I am going to, yes, and I'm going to meet their chiefs and assistant chiefs. I have asked the county commissioner to map out these numbers because I want to know every location and every sublocation, how many girls there became pregnant. And the sublocations that have got the highest number, we will interdict the assistant chief. Because we were supposed to work on this together. Sasa inaonekana kama tumefanya musaha na mambo kama haya. Na hii shida zingine ambazo tutazungumza na viongozi wa usalama pande hii. So, other than those challenges which we are prepared to deal with, the rest of it is okay. We will focus on the development projects here that must be sorted out. We will focus on the issues of title deeds. And I'm confident that His Excellency, our President, will be here shortly to now begin or kick off the process of issuing title deeds in this part of our country. So tuweke amani, hiyo ndio kitu ya maana. The last one, let us keep the peace. I have also been briefed about the incidents of robbery with violence in this town. We have seen a certain rise on that. I want to give you my word, residents of Kitale, we will solve that problem. We did not come here all the way from Nairobi to tell stories. I have told the regional police commander, watu wote na mambo ya eti kuna watu wanatembea hapa na AK-47, we will look for them and arrest them and sort them out. That is our job. This place must be peaceful, people must be peaceful to do their work. That is why they have a government. So hiyo mengine tutafanya vile tunafanya kwa mambo ya sheria na tutaelezana kule na machief na assistant chiefs, but we are going to have very stiff operation here to clean up those people and those gangs that are moving around here, terrorizing people at night and so on. We have never had a situation where we go to a place where we have had this. In fact, one of the reasons why I came is because of those reports. I've been seeing those reports every time when we receive the reports in the morning, you see some of those cases of robbery with violence and so on in Kitale, and we are going to sort them out. I can assure you, we will deploy, we have the resources, we have the means, and we are going to deploy the resources necessary to clean up that mess and ensure that people here are peaceful to go about their activities. That is why we have a government. Kazi ya serikali ni kuchunga wananchi na tutawachunga. Asante sana. To the chiefs and assistant chiefs. As my fellow civil servants, you know this. Shida ile tuko nayo pande hii ya Kitale, and that's why in Trans Nzoia we have these very alarming numbers. Ni mambo ya hii kitu inaitwa disco matanga. Ti watoto wanaenda huko sijui kufanya nini. I'm told that the police here is when someone has died, we must replace the deceased. Tunaenda huko to replace the deceased. Na watoto wetu, kuchesa na watoto wetu. So, tumekubaliana na county security team hapa. That thing is banned. Where is the county police commander? Where is banner? There will be no disco matanga in Trans Nzoia from now forever. Tumekubaliana. Mahali nafanyika, unafika hapo, you know what we do. Kwa watu wa security. Unachukua hiyo kinanda, unakamata watu wote, tunawapeleka kotini. Elewana? Hakuna mambo kama hayo, hakuna kitu inaitwa disco matanga tena Trans Nzoia. Tumekubaliana? Yeah, hii kitu, let me tell you the truth. Unajua, mnafikiri tunafanya hii kitu kama ni mzaa. Kilifi County was having this problem. Unfortunately, the county police commander who's here is the one I was dealing with in Kilifi with Mutindeka, who's now the regional commissioner in Nyanza. When we started dealing with teenage pregnancies in Kilifi, the numbers were very high. Na tukagundua hiyo ni ushenzi hiyo ya inaitwa disco matanga. And we said we are going to stamp this thing out. Tukaanza, tukakorogana kidogo, tukasukumana. Wakati wengine watu wa siasa wanasema we are being tough, lakini hiyo ndio kazi tunalipiwa mshahara kufanya. We are paid to protect our people. Sisi hatulipi kuambia watu story na kufurahisha mtu. We are not entertainers. Kazi yetu ni hiyo ya kulinda wananchi. Sasa, that gentleman unfortunately is now the county commander in Trans Nzoia. Na nimemwambia mtindo ni ule ule tuliweka huko Kilifi. Vile tulifanya pande ile ndivyo tutafanya hapa. Hakuna hiyo kitu siku ingine tena. Inaitwa disco matanga, hakuna. Mtu akipatikana yule mtu ambaye anakodisha hata kinanda tunachukua hiyo yote, tunafunga hao na tunakamata hao watu wako na hiyo kitu. Sababu hiyo maneno our children are in school, exams are starting on 22nd. Unafanya disco matanga kufanya nini? Hakuna hiyo kitu, tumekubaliana. County commissioner tumeelewana. Yes, yule sir. Chief ambaye assistant chief ambaye atakubali hiyo kitu ifanyike kwa village yake, tunatoa uniform yetu, tunatafuta mtu mwingine kuwa chief. We have to be serious. God has blessed us and given us children so that we raise them and take care of them they grow. Mungu akutupea watoto tuanze hii muzaa ya kucheza hapa hivi tunapeleka huko kuliplace juu nani amekufa. Kuliplace ni mambo ya Mungu na itafanya na adults sio watoto wetu. Asante sana.